On June 16th, North Korea said it wanted to reopen dialogue with the United States and suggested a high-level meeting. The North Korean proposal came 5 days after a high-level meeting between South and North Korean officials was called off. Foreign Ministry correspondent Hwang Sung-hee told us about the possible motives behind the sudden move. Officials at South Korea's foreign ministry say North Korea's recent behavior is part of a larger plan. How the events affect the future of South-North relations is being monitored.
Hwang Sung-hee, Arirang News.
The international community is moving fast, especially the member nations of the six-party talks following North Korea's proposal for dialogue. On June 19th, senior leaders of the six-party talks from South Korea, the United States, and Japan met in Washington, D.C. The gathering brought a consensus about the need for substantial progress on the issue of North Korea's nuclear disarmament through dialogue. National Assembly correspondent Kim Yun-ji reported on the key topics of the talks between South Korea, the United States, and Japan, as well as possible reactions from North Korea and China.
Arirang News.
The Nanjung Ilgi, or the War Diary of Admiral Lee Sun-shin, written by Chungmu-gong Lee Sun-shin during the Japanese invasion of Korea, and the documents from the Saemal Undong, or the New Village Movement, have made the UNESCO World Heritage List. Korea now boasts a total of 11 UNESCO World Heritage Treasures. Reporter Kim Ji-yeon told us about how Korea's treasures became UNESCO heritage items.
Horseback riding used to be thought of as a luxury pastime that could only be enjoyed by the rich, but those days may be changing. Horse-related industry is rising in a new sector that creates jobs and spur growth.
Well, a year has passed since the government has proposed a bill to spur growth of the horse-related industry, and I actually went to ride a horse and see how the industry is following up and how much support has been provided.
A class for future riding instructors is underway when Ji-sun arrives at the horse riding arena. As popularity of the horse riding industry continues to rise, the competition to secure work in the sector is heating up. Reporter Song Ji-sun has always wanted to cover a story about the horse industry as it plays into her interests in the sports and business sectors. The timing was right for a feature story since the topic has generated media interest amid visible progress in the sector.
So I've been following up this industry for nearly a year, and I wanted to actually check up on the industry and the people, like how many people are actually interested in becoming a part of this project. And actually, the change that I've seen during my report was amazing, because a lot of people were, more than I expected, were interested in becoming a part of the industry, such as being an instructor, not just an instructor, but as a doctor, or those who could actually take care of the farms and the horses. And in another perspective, racing horses, they could be used as a means of exports because Korea's Racing Association recently succeeded in exporting two racing horses that are bred from the very excellent breed of racing horses. This is one of the goals of the association as well as the related people. They want to change the conception of horses that there are more than just gambling and horse racing that there is.
일단 저희가 말산업 성장에 대한 전반적인 보도를 하고 있는데 네. 일단 이 부분은 이제 지금 뭐 자격증도 있고 뭐 지도사 교관을 많이 양성하잖아요. 네. 그래서 어떤 분들이 주로 오시고 뭐 어떤 목적을 갖고 하시나 네. 그런 부분으로 이제 몇 분 인터뷰 들어가고 네. 네. 그리고 지금 뭐 약간 지도사나 그런 강사 수요가 좀 얼마나 늘었는지 네. 어떻게 좀 보세요? 예전과 비교해서?
많이 늘었죠.
그리고 제가 보기엔 되게 어린데 어떻게 좀 학생층이 다양화가 됐나요? 보통 어떤 분들이
지금 이제 저기 보이는 친구들 같은 경우들도 다 그 말산업 특성화 고등학교
아~
고등학생 뭐 이런 학교들이 많이 생겨서 대학교들도 한 몇 개가 생기고요. 그래서 그쪽에서 이제 수요가 많이 창출되고 있죠. 저희 많이 이제 본인들이 더 배우고 싶은데.
지선 enters the stable to interview a student who's looking after a horse. But handling a horse is not a simple task.
야, 그거 안 돼. 그거 안 돼. 지금 어떤 일을 하는 거예요?
지금 마사 관리라고요.
얘 진짜
매일 가르치고 있어요.
또 어떤 관리를 해줘요, 이제? 말을 하면서?
우선 기본적으로는 마부 관리해주시고, 마사 관리하고요. 네. 솔질, 아니면 말 씻기거나 똑같이 이제 일반 동물들 키우는 거랑 별 차이 없게 해주고 자주 사람 손 타는 게 좋으니까 자주 만져주고
고맙습니다 어때요? 어떤 게 제일 좋아요?
그냥 실습할 때요 학교에서 재활성을 실습해 볼 때 애들 바뀌는 변화? 재활성을 하면서 이제 바뀌잖아요 애들이 그런 거 보면 약간 뿌듯한 그런 게 있잖아요
실제로 이제 좀 말도 좀 잘하고 어떻게 발전이 있어요, 애들이?
그것도 장애 정도에 따라서 그냥 빨리 보이는 게 있고 안 보이는 게 그래서요. 그냥 장애 정도에 따라서 좀 다르는데 애들이 엄청 좋아하니까요. 이게 치료 목적이 아니라 애들이 즐기는 목적으로도
After interviewing students, she heads out to cover a horseback riding rehabilitation program for special needs children. But getting permission from the parents comes first.
안녕하세요. 저희 아리랑 TV에서 나왔고요. 네, 저희가 지금 이제 승마랑 이제 한국의 이제 말 문화에 대해서 취재를 하고 있는데 이제 뭐 지도사 교육이라든가 이렇게 승마 교육이 있는 거에 대해서 지금 촬영을 하고 있거든요. 그래서 아이들이 이제 말 체험해 보고 이런 모습을 촬영하고 이제 느낌이 어떤지 이제 소감을 들어볼 건데 혹시 좀 불편하시다거나 촬영을 원하지는 않는 분이 계세요? 그러니까 이제. 이것뿐만 아니고 이제 다른 뭐 교육 프로그램이 많아가지고 같이 이제 나가는 거라서요. 네, 그럼 다 괜찮으신 걸로 봐도 될까요? 괜찮으세요? 네. 네.
The rehabilitation program aims to help people with disabilities through horseback riding. The three-dimensional movements of horses lead to physical exercise for the children, and the act of connecting with the horses improves social skills.
Hey, 안녕?
안녕하세요.
안녕하세요. 네. 너무 잘했어. 애가 너무 예뻐요. 지금 어디 앉을까? 엄마? 안 무서웠어? 괜찮았어? 말 예뻐요?
말 이름 뭐야? 말 이름 재즈야, 재즈. 재즈 해봐.
재즈. 지 오늘 타보니까 어땠어요?
좋아요. The child looks happy to have succeeded in riding the horse without the need for braces.
언제 또 타면 좋을까? 아까 말했던 거. 빨리 또 타고 싶다고.
빨리 또 매일매일 타고 싶어요. 크게 말해.
매일매일 타고 싶어요.
이거 타고서 어떤 효과가 났으면 좋으실 것 같아요, 좀?
저희가 보행에 좀 지장이 있는데, 예, 말을 타면 보행하는 데서 굉장히 그 근육들이 발달된다 그래서 이번 기회에 참가해가지고 우리 애가 이제 앞으로 좀 걷는 데 도움이 될까 해서 참가했습니다.
I actually have a cousin who is autistic, and I was by that obviously interested in like what ways could I like make his condition better. And through like cases, I've discovered that sports is one of the most effective way to actually improve a person's condition with intellectual disabilities. And I've also witnessed that during covering the story, there were some children who could not use their legs well, but they were okay on horses because they didn't really have to walk like on their feet. Rather, they were using horses as a means of their transportation, and they saw a lot of confidence, and they actually feel that their bodies reflect and react the way they intend or wish to be. So I think horseback riding was just an example, but sports itself could be actually the solution or an eventually a very good medication or a cure for these children or people with intellectual and physical disabilities.
That same afternoon, the third venue for the story is decided. Chi-sun continues her coverage with a look at horse racing, which accounts for a large portion of the horse industry. She contacted the headquarters of the Korea Racing Authority and suggested a meeting before the interview. The KRA is the promotional arm of Korea's horse industry.
좀 더 규제 완화에 있어서는 사실상 경마 쪽을 더 보시는 거 아닌가요?
아닙니다. 뭐 승마의 대중화라든지 이런 부분으로 이렇게 그 지향해 나가는 과정에서 실제 뭐 제도적이라든지 뭐 어떤 뭐 법률적, 뭐 정책적인 문제들로 인해서 그런 부분이 이렇게 쉽게 추진되지 못하는 부분들이 있는데 육성법을 통해서 이렇게 정책적으로 이렇게 지원하는 걸 해줘서 그런 부분이 이루어질 수 있도록 그런 완화를 해준다는 의미로 이해하시면 될 것 같아요.
When it comes to reporting or covering a story, I try to incorporate as many perspectives as I can because even though this is a governmental project, you need to have the private organization's view as well as the administrative point of view, that being the Korea Racing Association and the Ministry of Agriculture as well as sports. And I also want to have the general public's point of view because no matter how many times I say this is amazing, people are not going to really say that or conceive it as the way I do. So I always have try to have at least three point of view, that being the government and the public and a professional. That's a basic essential of my interview with Least, and I try to do that the same way this time around, just that it was like I wanted to go to a lot of places at just like one or two days, and that was a lot to cover, especially given this is a five-year project that's still ongoing.
A day after covering the story about the Korea Racing Association, Chi-sun went on to do an interview. This time with a government official at the Ministry of Agriculture, Food and Rural Affairs, which is in charge of the Horse Industry Promotional Act.
강의실은 여기 5강의실이요?
예.
There was a lecture for provincial government officials in charge of the horse industry, so she decided to take it in before the interview. It was an unplanned event for the crew.
여기는 지금 당에 지가 말을 꺼내 가지고 타고 이렇게 그 가는데 우리는 전부 그래서 6차 산업 과제로 지금 우리 내부 과제로 농림부에서 채택이 됐습니다.
It's not rare for Ji-sun to go out of her way to look for extra stories, even though she's there for an interview. The Horse Industry Promotional Act is the world's first horse-related legislation. By covering the story, Ji-sun had a chance to look into the early stages of the five-year long-term project.
I feel I've closed a chapter, but I also feel like I've opened another one because it's just the beginning and it's been just year one, and there's four more years go, and what I'm looking forward to is actually the next five-year project that's going to start from 2017, after the first 2016, the five-year project is completed. If people or the government do not, you know, follow up or push forward with this project, it's not going to be continued. You know how like people start a lot of projects and constructions, whatever it is, and if they don't follow up or like keep pushing or support the people who are involved in it, the industry is not going to continue its growth. So I want to actually follow up this project until the five-year project is completed, and when the next plan is released, I will also try to cover that with the basis of the story and back.
On the broadcast tonight, just 5 days after North Korea pulled out of inter-Korean talks, it initiates dialogue with the U.S.
Korea's Hanwha Nuclear Reactor No. 5 resumed operation.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Now in North Korea. However, the lack of transparency in distribution exists. Join us as we bring you to the galleries where it is taking place.
So I'll be, I'm actually filling in for Kang Young. I'm pretty sure you've visited us many times. But these are some of the questions that, preliminary questions.
Those are good.
To me, like as a South Korean, it's almost like insulting that North Korea just walks away from the inter-Korean talks and it goes to the U.S., almost sending a message that we can't talk to you, South Koreans, but we want to talk to the U.S.
Yes.
So we'll, how do you think the U.S. should respond? Like, should this be first left as a family affair between the two Koreas?
The U.S. will respond in coordination with the South Korea, but actually cannot rule out the possibility of bilateral talks, as they did in the previous cases. For example, they had talks in Berlin, and that talk produced what they call it, the agreement between the two. And also in the Geneva Agreement, also the U.S. actually directly engaged in the dialogue with the DPRK. Of course, at that time, we were left out. If North Korea offered so what they call sweet deals, which cannot be denied by the United States. So we cannot rule out the possibility of that one, but actually what must be emphasized is collective responses. So
if that solves the problem, then we might have to go that track. Would you see that as the desirable track?
I don't think it's desirable, but anyway, if there's a prior consultation between South Korea and the United States about the bilateral consultation or bilateral support with DPRK, that's fine with us. But if the United States does not consult with the other concerned parties at all and then just go in directly to the talks with DPRK, that would cause a problem of coordination and also in the alliance with the U.S.
I used to cover the defense ministry for a year and a half. And to me, my question is always like, how much should we be concerned? Because from the outside world, just sometimes we overdramatize some of the news that we deliver about North Korea. So in this particular case right now, how much different or concerning is the North Korea's behavior?
I haven't seen any serious, real threatening behavior of North Korea. It's all about rhetorics, narratives. Actually, the media covered the rhetoric's too much, and also maybe that creates some kinds of
unnecessary fear.
Unnecessary fear on the part of South Korea and also outside the world, of course. If you watch the CNN or the BBC, they're all breaking news. Actually, like, war is very
World War III is like
that. So they just looked at the rhetorics and not only the real the action.
And you know, there's this reoccurring cycle of you know, dialogue being broken and like threats and like dialogue. Can we at least hope for something good might come out of this?
Of course.
Can we break this cycle?
I think that's possible, because actually there's two things. One, of course, we have to maintain our very robust defense posture, which will deny any possibility of North Korea's provocation. That's the first one. Second, of course, now everybody's emphasizing the negotiation talks with DPRK. If North Korea shows its sincerity and proves itself by doing concrete action, that will become the beginning of departure from the previous pattern.
I'll just leave this with you.
Okay.
Like, we might change the wording a little bit.
Okay. No problem. Yep. 네. 안녕하세요. 네. 네.
네. 네. 네. So what are North Korea's intentions and what can we expect next? To help us answer these questions and maybe more, we have Dr. Choi Gang. Welcome, Dr. Choi.
Good to be back here.
Right, thanks for being here with us.
What is this? Is this a sign of desperation from North? North Korea should take very concrete action to show its determination to declare itself. The North Korea challenge in the coming days and years ahead of us.